Today let us learn the chapter Applications of Percentage. What is percent? How to convert the fractions to percent, or percent to fractions, fractions to decimals, decimals to fractions, and simple sums based on these. Let us go into learn. Okay? Percent means out of 100. Percent means out of 100. Okay? If I say, and you know that the sign for percent symbol is this. 25% means 25 by 100. Same way, 69% means 69 by 100. 8% means 8 by 100. Okay? 950% means 950 by 100. That means percent means out of 100. Now, you know these are the fractions. Percent to fraction we have converted. If you want to convert to decimals, simply what you have to do? 25 by 100. If the denominator is 1 and some zeros, write the numerator. After two places, put a decimal. Same way, 69 by 100 means write 69. After two places, put a decimal. 8 by 100 means write 8. 100 means after two places. But here only one place is there. One more zero, write decimal and zero. Same way, write 950. After two places, you put a decimal. That means it is becoming 9.58. The given number may be a fraction, may be a decimal, may be a natural number. When you want to convert to percentage, simply always multiply by 100%. Let me show you what is that. Suppose it is given as 2 by 5. Convert to fraction means, percent means 2 by 5 into 100%. 520 is a. That gives you 40%. So if the given number is, whether it is a fraction or a decimal or a whole number, multiply by 100%, you will get percentage. 2 by 5. Let me give you one more example. 4 by 9. If you want to convert to percentage, 4 by 9 into 100%. We are not able to cancel, we will get 400 by 9%. Whenever you get the answer in improper, convert it to mixed. 9 4 are 36, 40. 9 4 are 36, again 4 left out. So these are the fractions. If you want to convert to percentage, multiply by 100%. I told, if the given is a decimal also, see, same example will take 0.25, the decimal number. If you want to convert to percentage, multiply by 100%, I said. You will get 2500. After two places, decimal is there? Decimal. That means 25%. Is it not 25%? Let me explain you this. The given decimal is 9.5. Convert to percentage into 100%. 95 into 100 is 9500. After one place decimal, that means 950% is. We got it or not? Okay. So percentage to fraction, fraction to decimal. Here from fraction to percentage, here decimal to percentage. How to convert? Remember that if the given number is whatever it may be, if you want to convert to percentage, you have to multiply by 100%. Now basing on this, some more examples and the little different variety of questions, let me give you. If the question is a little different, these are simple ones, I explain you. Suppose the question is 15% of a number is equal to 45. Okay, 15% of a number is 45. Find the number. Find the number. Simple example I'm giving you. We don't know what is the number in maths, particularly whatever you don't know. If you want to know something, you take it as x. Let the number be x. Let the number be x. Just simply come back to the question. 15% of a number, that means 15% of a number is x, is means equal to 45. That implies 1500 into x is equal to 45. That implies x is equal to 45 into 100 by 15. 15 ones are 15, 3 is 300. So what is the number? X is 300 means. Therefore, the number is 300. Or the required number is 300. Okay. Let me explain you one more problem. So your next question is this. There are 12% boys in a school. If the number of boys is 36, find the number of girls and the total number of students. There are 12% boys. That means 12% of the students are boys. So let us take number of students at x. Let total number of students is equal to x. If total number of students are x, it is given that 12% are boys. Okay, number of boys is equal to 12% of x. And also it is given that if the number of boys is 36, that means percentage is 12%, number is 36. That means 12% of total number of students is 36. Let us simplify this. 12 by 100 into x is 36, or x is equal to 36 into 100 by 12. 12 ones are 12, 3 is 300. So what we got? X is equal to 300. What is x? Total number of students. This one we already got. And number of boys is given. Number of girls, you have to find out. You know, the number of girls equal to total number of students minus number of boys. 10 minus 6, 4. 9 minus 3, 6, 2. 264. Therefore, number of girls, whenever the question is asked, a last statement should be written clearly. Number of girls is 264 and the number of students is equal to 300. Number of students equal to 300, or you can write total number of students. I think it is clear to you. Please go through and try to understand. You'll be able to understand well and do the sums well. Thank you.